Hey everybody, welcome to Jimmy's Records and Tapes. I'm Jimmy Pardo. This week we're talking about 1977.
We've got it on vinyl, CD and cassette.
We've got pop, rock, heavy metal, punk, funk, rap, and new wave. All sales are final, but you never regret all the music you get at Jimmy's Records and Tapes.
I'm loving music again.
Hey everybody, indeed, welcome into Jimmy's Records and Tapes, the show, of course, where I take you down memory lane via my record collection. This week, 1977, what was happening in the world in 1977? Well, Atari 2600 debuted. I don't know when we bought ours, but we had one, and boy, did we love it. Also, sad day, August 16th of 77, we lost the king, we lost Elvis Presley. I was at the pool, the Oak Lawn, I wish I could remember the name of it, the Oak Lawn Public Pool, let's call it that. And everybody had their radios on, and the news came over, and one woman went, "No! No!" And then I just kept slashing around because I was a child who didn't care about Elvis Presley. Star Wars, I cared about. That was the biggest movie of the year, of course, along with Saturday Night Fever. What could your money get you in 1977? Well, I'm here to tell you. For 65 cents, get yourself a gallon of gas, my friend. You want to buy a house? Sure. Why not? $49,000. To buy a house, and if you want a wrist AM radio, that's going to cost you $8. I had one of those, probably for my birthday or for Christmas. I don't know which one, but I did have that, and that was inconvenient and sounded horrible, but I thought I was Dick Tracy and had the coolest thing in the world, and nobody else found it as cool as I did. The best-selling song was Rod Stewart's Tonight's the Night. The best-selling album was Rumours by Fleetwood Mac, and Rolling Stones' album of the year was Trans-Europe Express by Kraftwerk. That makes sense. But I'm going to talk about something for my collection. I'm going to be talking about Styx's The Grand Illusion. Now, this is the seventh album by Styx. It was released on 7/7/77, July 7th of 77, the seventh album. And it went all the way to, getting what's happening here, Billboard's number six. A little too successful. You'd think they probably hoped, oh, don't sell, but keep us at seven, so everything can be sevens. I loved this album. This was the very first album I ever bought with my own money. First album that wasn't a gift for a birthday or Christmas. This was the one with my money from having a paper route, or route, you decide what part of the country you're from. I went and bought this. And the first 45 I ever bought was Three Dog Nights, The Show Must Go On. But this was the first album. And it came with a poster that I would hang on my wall. And I just was crazy for this album, mainly because I felt like an adult that I bought my first album. All my friends and my girlfriend, Laura, at the time, that's right, I was 11 years old and I had a girlfriend. And Laura, by the way, taught me how to French kiss. And I was not prepared for that. I was not prepared to, when I'm going in for a simple smooch, for an open mouth and a tongue attacking me. Boy, that was a surprise. As much of a surprise as how much I love this album. What I remember is about this album is that there was these two brothers whose names I will not remember. Their last name was Kennedy. No relation, of course, to Camelot's Kennedy, Kennedys. But the Kennedy brothers also loved this album, and they would bring it around on their, they had one of those portable 8-track players, and they would bring it around everywhere they went. And one of the Kennedys stole Laura away from me. And I remember wanting to fight them. And I showed up as I saw them making out on the swings at the grade school. I was with my buddy Paul and my buddy Chris, and I was going to get revenge on whatever Kennedy brother this was for taking Laura. And it was in the middle of the winter. And it was, again, as a gift, I was given a one of those switchblade combs. And I pulled it out. I said, "Hey, you got away from her." And I pulled it out and hit the button and the comb opened. And one of the Kennedy brothers' buddies went, "Oh, he's got a comb." And I, instead of looking tough, looked like a jackass. Years later, I would manage a record store in Matteson, Illinois. And not too far away was a neighborhood called Prestwick, where Dennis DeYoung of Styx, who wrote Come Sail Away and the great album title, album track, The Grand Illusion, he would come and shop. And Dennis would call the store before he would come. And he would go, hey, this, how you doing? This is Dennis. I'm going to be coming in shopping. Don't make a big deal out of it. Which meant, make a big deal out of it. So Dennis would show up. We would, of course, put all of his albums in the front rack so that it looked like we were really promoting his latest album. I believe Desert Moon was the album at the time. It could have been Back to the World. I'm not 100% sure. And Dennis and his wife, Suzanne, would come in. He would be wearing his Styx tour jacket. She would be wearing a fur coat. But for the love of God, don't make a big deal out of it. I make fun of Dennis, but the truth is, he wrote one of my favorite songs of all time. This album remains to be in my top five. And Dennis is a great guy. Whether the other guys in Styx think so, that's not for me to say. As a guy who, my few run-ins with Dennis, he was always very nice and kind. One time, he brought his son Matthew, who I now believe does lights for a lot of recording artists for their concerts. Matthew came in and Dennis said, hey, it's my son's birthday this weekend. I haven't gone shopping yet. Will you guys watch Matthew while I go do that? And we're like, yeah, of course we'll babysit Dennis DeYoung's kid. So my buddy Keith and I babysat Dennis DeYoung's kid while Dennis went out shopping. And we're kind of just idiots ourselves, 19, 20 years old, don't know how to really entertain a kid. So we're trying to entertain him. We're trying to keep him busy. And that, of course, meant we would bother him and talk to him nonstop. And at one point, he just went, I'm done talking to you. And he may as well have just kicked me in the balls. That's how bad that hurt my feelings. And then Dennis came back with his package all wrapped up so that nobody would see what it was. He said, thank you. And I said, no, it was a joy. Your son is a joy. Quick side story. Tommy Shaw, who wrote the great song Fooling Yourself, my second favorite song on the album, once joined us for Podcastathon, the event that my podcast Never Not Funny does to raise money for Smile Train. Tommy joined us and helped us raise a ton of dough that year. So I thank him for that. The guys in Styx have always been very kind to me, and I thank them by letting Grand Illusion remain in my top five. Otherwise, obviously, it'd be at number seven. Hey, it's time for this week's quick hit, and it's Bill Conti's Gonna Fly Now. You know what better is the theme from Rocky. Went to number one on the Billboard chart. Went to number 20 on the Adult Contemporary chart. I don't know why I felt that part was important to tell you. It was released February 28th, last day of the month. Right, let's get it out there. But everybody, you know, I don't know anybody that doesn't run to this day that at some point they don't have that song in their head. And my brother and I, man, we Rockied everything up. We would, we would run around the neighborhood. Nobody would join us like we were Rocky, but we would play Follow the Leader with each other. And it's just a song that when that comes on my shuffle when I'm running, just gives me that extra boost. And you just envision Rocky going up those steps in that iconic scene from that movie. There was a disco version that also charted. And then oddly, Maynard Ferguson did a jazz version that broke the top 30. So everybody was crazy for Rocky. Hey everybody, thanks for joining me here on this week's episode of Jimmy's Records and Tapes. If you dug it, click like, click subscribe. Want to know more about me? I'm at Jimmy Pardo on Twitter. And you can listen to my award-winning podcast, Never Not Funny, wherever you get your podcasts, or Spotify, Apple Podcasts, wherever they are. Until then, the record store is closed.